Hey folks, it's Jim from the Movie One, and I'm here to review the highly anticipated Steven Spielberg film, Lincoln. Lincoln follows the 16th president's last 4 months in office, where Abraham is trying to get enough votes from the Republican and Democratic Party to pass the 13th Amendment and abolish slavery, while also trying to put an end to the Civil War. Now, I had some reservations about Lincoln. I hated the trailer. It looked like everything that I feared that it would be. Manipulative, overly sentimental, fake, phony, forced, and calculated. All those things. I wasn't really a big fan of Spielberg's latest effort with War Horse. For some people, that movie worked. For me, it didn't. And it was more or less, for me, just kind of a mediocre Hallmark card. And there's really no, you know, recipe or formula as to why sentimentality can sometimes work for you and sometimes it doesn't. And I thought War Horse was just trying too much. It was too artificial, too fake and phony, and I just really didn't care for that film. I thought it was Spielberg really on autopilot. But Lincoln almost addresses criticisms of Spielberg, and I feel like he does learn from his mistakes to a certain extent. I think Spielberg is a great filmmaker. He's made great films. He's made some bad films. Usually the criticisms given to him I kind of agree with regarding sometimes his occasional sentimentality. Sometimes that's more than justified, sometimes it doesn't really work in his films. To my surprise, though, I think Lincoln is a very good film. It's going to be a movie that's going to divide some people because I think people are going to have certain expectations when it comes to this movie because Spielberg is directing it. There are no big sweeping battle sequences, which is kind of disappointing just considering that Spielberg is the one behind the camera. But I also like how Spielberg is sort of subverting expectations one might have for his film. I also like that the film only focused on the last 4 months of Lincoln's life rather than his entire lifespan. Is he an interesting enough figure for us to watch a movie about his entire life? Sure, most certainly, but I thought it was a refreshing and smart move to only focus on a few things about Lincoln that really define who he is rather than having a movie where we see little Lincoln, Abraham Lincoln, as a baby to him on his deathbed. That can be such an easy way to elicit emotions from your audience, and I think there are more subtle ways to move your audience. Before I get to the performances, I just want to say that the film is impressive on a technical level, no surprise, with Spielberg directing, the production design, the costumes, and also the beautiful photography within the picture. There's not a lot of sweeping shots of the Civil War or anything like that. A lot of the sequences happen within doors, but I still think that the film, because of Spielberg's production design and the film's photography, the film never feels too stuffy or dry, and there's just a lot of nice subtle camera movements from zoom-ins and zoom-outs, and also just a lot of long takes, so you can really engage with the performances. Now, this has, without question, the most prolific cast of any film this year, maybe even last year. It's just a ridiculous cast. Not a lot of female actresses, but it has plenty of great male character actors, and they're all led by, of course, Daniel Day-Lewis as Abraham Lincoln, maybe the best actor of his generation. He's absolutely great, and he kind of goes against the depiction of what people have of Lincoln in terms of Lincoln having a very deep voice. Instead, Day-Lewis has this sort of weary, tired voice that's perfect for storytelling to his peers. And the more I thought about it, I started to think maybe this is exactly how Lincoln would talk. And that's always a treat, usually, to see him act, even though I wasn't really a big fan of his performance in Nine. But he really is such a great actor, and he truly becomes his character. It's so cliche to say that, but it just perfectly applies to the actor. He's absolutely great in the film. It's probably not my favorite performance of his, but I think it's excellent work by him, and I would not be surprised if he was nominated and maybe even won the Academy Award. The rest of the supporting cast is just as great as well. You have Sally Field as Mary, Lincoln's distressed wife after losing her child, and she doesn't want to lose her other son, Robert, played by Joseph Gordon-Levitt, who wants to have a part in the Civil War. And yeah, I think Sally Field is, you know, a bit too old for Mary. I think she's 65 right now, and I believe Mary was like 45
at the time of Lincoln's eventual death, but I still think she gives a very good performance. There's Hal Holbrook as Francis Preston Blair, a Republican who tried to arrange a peace agreement between the Confederacy and the Union. The always great David Sharon plays Lincoln's Secretary of State, William Seward. Tommy Lee Jones is so good as Thaddeus Stevens, a Republican who doesn't always see eye to eye with Lincoln, but wants the same things, particularly to abolish slavery. James Spader nearly threatens to steal the entire movie as William N. Bilbo, a Democratic Party operative. And the list goes on, we'd be here all day. Just an absurd cast. John Hawkes, Tim Blake Nelson, you have Jared Harris, Jackie O'Haley as a Confederate States Vice President. You have Walton Goggins, Michael Stuhlbarg, Lucas Haas shows up for like 2 minutes. The actor who plays Gale from Breaking Bad, David Costabile. I'm sure this cast will be like nominated for the Screen Actors Guild SAG. Hey folks, sorry I had to run some errands, so I'm in the car right now, but I want to get back to what I was saying. I really like the portrayal of Lincoln. I like how he isn't just some saint or Christ-like figure. He's portrayed as a flawed individual at times, and he does some things that are considerably shady, and I really like that portrayal of Lincoln, and I really enjoy the film. It's a bit stuffy. You do have white characters talking in a room for most of the picture, and maybe the film would have been tighter if you took out some of the family drama with his wife and his son. And it's occasionally a little bit too long, maybe there's one too many speeches and things like that, and sometimes it's sort of sentimental, but maybe it's not a bad subject to be really sentimental about. But overall, I did enjoy the film. I'm kind of torn as to what rating I want to give the film, because part of me wants to say see it twice, because I kind of want to see it again. Part of me just wants to say see it, and another part wants me to say rent it, because it's not really a big cinematic film. But then again, if you know me or Tom, you know that we kind of just prefer good movies. It doesn't matter if Transformers 3 is a more cinematic movie than Moneyball. I don't like Transformers 3 at all, and I would rather see Moneyball any day of the week over Transformers 3, if you get what I'm saying. Is it a good film? And Lincoln is a very good film. Maybe one of the year's best, maybe the year's best. So I'm going to give it a see it, right between a see it twice and a rent it. I think it's a pretty good film. I think it's a good film to see, particularly with your family. I think it's a good matinee kind of film, and I really enjoyed it, and I think there's some great performance, some great production design, and a fairly well-written script. It's got some problems here and there, but for the most part, I think this is kind of a return to form for Spielberg. Is it one of his 5 best films, or even his 10 best films? I'm not so sure about that, but it's definitely a step up in the right direction for him. And I think it's worth checking out, and might be really the definitive Lincoln film. And that's it for the movie. Well, have a good day, folks. Until next time.